Gideon's grammar curriculum teaches a step-by-step approach to mastery learning. Remember to read all directions carefully and work slowly for accuracy and to avoid too many corrections. In Grammar Booklet 3M, the student will learn how to correctly use perfect and progressive verbs in a sentence. Located on the front inside cover of this booklet is a reference list containing all of the verbs used in this booklet in past, progressive, and perfect form. Here is how the list works. If you'd like to find the past, progressive, and perfect form of the verb ask, find the word located underneath the designated column. You will find that the past form of ask is asked, the progressive form of ask is asking, and the perfect form of ask is asked. Let's take a look at perfect tense verbs. Taught is the perfect tense form of teach. As you can see, present perfect, past perfect, and future perfect all use the same form of teach, which is taught. Since each uses the same verb, what depicts if it is present, past, or future perfect? In present perfect tense, you must use have or has as the helping verb before the main verb. Molly has taught English classes at Brookhaven College. As another example, this time using have, those women have taught English classes at Brookhaven College. The reason it is important to remember that either have or has can be used here is due to subject-verb agreement. With a singular noun or pronoun, you must use has. She has taught high school classes. With a plural noun or pronoun, you must use have. They have taught high school classes. In past perfect tense, you must use had as the helping verb before the main verb. Kavita had taught her sister how to ride a bike. In future perfect tense, you must use will have before the main verb. Boston will have taught his dog how to fetch by tomorrow. Now let's move on to progressive tense verbs. Teaching is the progressive form of teach. Now let's look at present progressive verbs. Molly is teaching English classes at Brookhaven College. You must use is or are as a helping verb in front of the main verb when writing in present progressive tense. As an example using are in present progressive tense, the boys are teaching the girls how to play football. When the subject is singular, you must use is. Molly is teaching. When your subject is plural, you must use are. The boys are teaching. Let's look at past progressive tense. Kavita was teaching her sister how to ride a bike. You must use was or were as the helping verb before the main verb in past progressive tense. As an example using were, Kavita's parents were teaching her good manners. When your subject is singular, you must use was. Kavita was teaching. When your subject is plural, you must use were. Parents were teaching. Lastly, let's look at future progressive tense. Boston will be teaching his dog how to fetch tomorrow. You must use will be as the helping verb before the main verb in future progressive tense. Let's move on to the exercises on page 1. We will choose the correct form of the verb for the sentence. Let's take a look at number 1. She has come, had came, or has coming to school before. Notice how each choice contains the helping verbs has and had. We know that has and had are both used as perfect tense helping verbs. From these clues, we now know that the main verb must be in perfect tense form. Referring back to the list on the front inside cover of the booklet, we need to look for the word come in perfect tense form, which is come. So we now know that has come is the correct choice to this question. Let's look at another example. The farmer is milked, will be milking, or have milked the cows later today. Notice how later today is underlined. This indicates that the verb will take action in the future, meaning it must be a future tense verb. By this, we know the verb will be future tense, making the correct answer will be milking. The farmer will be milking the cows later today. Now let's move on to the next activity on this page, where we will practice creating our own sentence. Create a sentence with to grow in past tense form. We can refer back to the verb list on the front inside cover of this booklet and see that grew is the past tense form of grow. We will now create a sentence using grew. John grew very tall last year. Now, let's create a sentence with to grow in past progressive tense. Again, we will refer back to our verb list, find grow, and see that growing is the progressive form of grow. Since it is asking for past progressive, we know we must use was before growing. Sarah was growing roses in her garden. Lastly, let's create a sentence using to grow in past perfect tense. After looking at the verb list, we know that grown is the perfect form of grow. Since it asks for past perfect tense, we know that we must use had before grown. Carla had grown 4 inches taller since last summer. For any further questions or explanations, please ask your Gideon instructor.